Hello and welcome to another tutorial from Milan Creative Co. I'm Christina and in this week's tutorial I will show you how to create a seamless marble texture in Photoshop. Open Photoshop and create a new document. I'm going to start with a square canvas that's 800 by 800 pixels. Make sure that the background is set to white and click Create to continue. We are going to create a marble texture from scratch using Photoshop filters. Before we get started, set your colors to the default option by pressing on the default foreground and background colors button or by pressing D on your keyboard. Also, double click on the background layer to unlock it. The first filter we are going to use is Difference Clouds. So go to Filter, Render, Difference Clouds. Add it again until you see these lines on your canvas. Now go to Image, Adjustments, Equalize. The small change will make the light parts of the image white and the dark parts black. Go again to Image, Adjustments, Level. Move this arrow from the middle almost all the way to the left. The lighter parts of the image should be white and you should also see these black veins. Press OK to save it. The next step is to duplicate your layer. So go to the Layers panel. Right-click on your layer and select Duplicate Layer from the menu. If the layer panel is not open, go to Window Layers or press F7 on your keyboard. We are going to add another filter, so go back to Filter, Distort, Twirl. Set the angle to 50 degrees and press OK. This step is actually optional, but I think it makes the marble texture look a little bit better. Let's rotate the top layer, so go to Edit, Transform and rotate 90 degrees clockwise. The last step is to change the blending mode of the top layer from normal to screen. And this will be our marble texture. It actually looks like real marble. So if you don't want to edit it anymore, just select both layers, right click on them and choose Merge Layers. Now I want to show you how to make a seamless marble texture. So with the layer selected, go to Filter, Other, Offset. As you can see, Photoshop has already entered the values of 400 pixels right for the horizontal value and 400 pixels down. Now, you might remember that my canvas is 800 by 800 pixels. So when you use the Offset filter, just enter half the value of your canvas. Press OK to save it. Our texture is not seamless yet, so we have these lines in the middle of the canvas. Now we are going to use the Clone Step tool to copy areas of the marble and use them to replace these areas here where we have the line. So set your brush to a larger size. I'm going to use 100 pixels, I think it's large enough. And bring the hardness down to 10%. So let's look for an area that's similar to this area. I'm just going to hold down the Alt key and click on this area to copy it. And then I'm just going to click here to replace this. I think this looks perfect. So you are going to have to do this for all the texture. The texture looks much better now, so I'm going to use the offset filter again. And as you can see, there are a few lines on the edges of the canvas, so I'm just going to use the Clone Step tool again. Our texture is now seamless, so to define it as a pattern, go to Edit, Define Pattern and enter your name here. Click OK to save it. If you want to test it, go to File, New and open a new canvas that's larger than your marble texture. I'm going to set the width to 1600 pixels and the height to 1600 pixels. Now I'll just go to Edit, Fill, and choose your marble texture. As you can see, our marble texture is seamless and you can use it on all your projects. So let's go back to this texture and recolor it. The easiest way to change the color of the marble is by adding an adjustment layer. So go to the bottom of your layers palette and choose solid color from the adjustments layer. I'm going to select this dark purple and change the blending mode from normal to screen. This will change the veins from black to this dark purple. Now I'm going to make this invisible and add another solid color layer. I'm going to use this light yellow and change the blending mode from normal to multiply. This will change the background color. Now if you want to change the background color, you should use a lighter color, and if you want to change the color of the veins, you should use a darker color. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial, and if you want to see more tutorials, please visit my blog or subscribe to my channel. I release a new design tutorial every week. Goodbye!